most of my family gaming with my Kevin running here. And hope you're having a good day, guys. As y'all see, we still with this SmackDown hacker. Who is this SmackDown hacker? Who? We will rise. Who will rise? Huh? I feel like he's watching everyone. Just not SmackDown or Raw. He watching everyone in the whole world. Nah. Yeah, we another video of the SmackDown hacker. He sent a message.
Hello and welcome to the Saturday News. My name is Bill.
I guess these people gonna talk about the SmackDown hacker.
He does in Louisiana. Who knew there was a place called?
Okay, freaky. This is not the one I'm gonna share, y'all.
For months, WWE has been teasing a debut.
We never seen Roman Reigns. Roman Reigns could be the SmackDown hacker. Yeah, guys. Because I want y'all to hear this for y'all self. Because we still on these videos of the SmackDown hacker. What he up to? Why is he watching WWE Superstars? Okay, yes. As y'all see, this SmackDown hacker, he hijacked WWE backstage. I'm gonna lay out super
nice. You know what I mean? So I'm really excited about it. I want to know who it is. It could be any of us, Renee. Could be any of us here.
I think it could be CM Punk.
Oh, you put it out there?
Come on, guys.
It could be.
Y'all missing the cold words here, man. The cold word telling.
It could be Roman Reigns. We right never there, saw him until a long time. Until Roman, he didn't say, I want your home for this thing to happen. Type in a code. Okay, the code was 025.
You know, with Kennedy, now this is real.
Bro, why is he the new proof of female SmackDown hacker didn't bring WWE? True! Randy Rousey can be the female hacker.
What is going on, guys? It is WrestleMania here, back with some more news. Join us now. WrestleMania looks at the wildest news stories and rumors you need to know, including AEW wrestlers exposed to an infected person with coronavirus. More hints at the WWE hackers' identity.
We're not talking about coronavirus.
SummerSlam plans kept a secret. Jeez. Tom Swister was supposed to break the Undertaker's streak, but turned it down. Becky breaks a new record. And a fired superstar was set to become Intercontinental Champion. Be sure to subscribe and hit that notification bell for daily wrestling videos. But hit the intro because it's now time for the news.
Hey, go ahead and guess the news about this SmackDown heckle.
Now our first story looks at AEW wrestlers exposed to an infected person with coronavirus. With professional wrestlers and MMA fighters continuing to work through the ongoing pandemic, there is justified concern that someone would become infected and, even worse, infect others around them. Ringside News is reporting on a potentially scary situation.
What are you talking about coronavirus? This time is a new proof of female SmackDown hack I didn't bring.
Ronaldo Souza and two of his tournament tested positive for coronavirus ahead of UFC 249. Dave Meltzer discussed this situation in depth during the Wrestling Observer Radio. Shakira lives in Orlando, so he drove to Jacksonville with his cornerman in the same car. Reaction to an outbreak. Next up, more hints at the WWE hacker's identity. The SmackDown hacker appeared again on 8th May, and once again, fans are speculating as to who the mystery man or woman's identity is. A number of stories have gone around concerning who it might be, with WrestlingNews.co's Paul Davis discussing
title at Money in the Bank. So that's the...
So this guy's crazy. He talking about coronavirus.
So things look like they're finally picking up in the SmackDown hacker storyline. For weeks now, the SmackDown hacker has been posting small teasers, and we've been following them closely, but now it looks like we're finally getting exposure of the next target. The SmackDown hacker finally appeared on SmackDown.
Hope the next target is Mandy Rose. I bet that's the next target.
Recently, with his latest new video, and revealed a lot of new information. Between the voicemail clip and the Money in the Bank clip, we learned a lot of new things. WWE has been reusing the same footage of the hacker for every single teaser, so far, since we first saw him. We have the footage of him looking at the screens, then some other footage of him spinning around in the chair, and then the footage of him raising his hand and pressing the button. But that's about all the footage there was of the SmackDown hacker before Money in the Bank. But one of the things the Money in the Bank clip showed us was a closer look at their workplace. Before, we only saw two screens, but now the hacker zooms out and we see hundreds of screens. This was way bigger than we thought it was. The hacker talks about everyone wanting to know who he is, but he responds by letting everyone know that he is everywhere. We see a quick montage of voicemails, text messages, phone calls, and multiple different camera angles. The meaning of this montage was to tell you that the hacker can get access to pretty much anything he pleases, from a phone call to a text message. Nothing is impossible to get for him. Taking a look at the hundreds of screens we saw in their room, the hacker has cameras on literally everyone. So if anything goes wrong concerning whatever superstar, he'll be coming to expose them right away. Right before Money in the Bank aired, I was ready to talk about how the SmackDown hacker clips were getting a bit dull and repetitive because they kept recycling the same footage of him. But Money in the Bank definitely gave us some actual new footage of the hacker and his room, and it sparked a whole new level of discussion. But one of the main new things we did get recently in the story was the reveal of this private voicemail message. The SmackDown hacker teased earlier in the week that he had a private voice message from a WWE superstar. And finally on SmackDown, he revealed that message. He hears what definitely seems to be a woman's voice, yep. And she says, "I'll tell you one thing, payback is coming, and it's coming real soon." So now the biggest question is, of course, who was that voice?
He said that voice got to be Sasha, guys. So here I think, Sasha, she said payback is coming, right, in the voicemail. So Sasha's trying to get her payback from Bayley for not letting her talk.
The voicemail. We really got two routes here. It's either the target speaking that the hacker's tracking, or it's one of the hackers themselves warning us about the payback that is coming to the roster. But if I had to pick, I'll definitely say that this is one of the targets in the voicemail. It seems, at least in the story, that the target was calling another superstar just to vent about what issues she was going through. But the message was picked up by the SmackDown hacker. which of course you can say is a bit unrealistic, but he's a hacker. So technically the character can get away with stealing anything, and we have to accept it, because it makes sense. So who's the superstar behind the voice? Everyone's first guess is Sasha Banks. Just go back and look at that teaser clip once more and see how it starts and how it ends. It starts with Sasha getting pinned during her embarrassing loss from a few weeks ago, and it ends with that line from that woman's voice. So Sasha Banks fits right into that whole situation and description. The other women shown in that clip are Carmella and Dana Brooke, and even though it's possible that the issue could be between them two, I just don't see that happening at all. The exposure of Carmella and Dana Brooke is pretty anticlimactic.
So we're trying to find who is the boy voice and the girl voice. But the more we already know who is the boy voice, but we got to find out who is that girl voice under that voice man. I think we already know who the boy hacker is. It got to be Ali. Yeah, I've been seeing him a lot of times.
So take a quick second to click that subscribe button so you won't miss any new videos. Let's get back into the story. Sasha and Bayley did seem pretty alright on SmackDown recently, but they still had some miscommunication issues and did lose their tag team match, which also continues Sasha's long and dreadful losing streak. Sasha hasn't won a single match since long before WrestleMania, so that could play a big part in all of this frustration that's building up with Sasha for this payback. Bayley also didn't let Sasha speak and answer a question during a Money in the Bank interview, and Sasha once again saved Bayley's title at Money in the Bank, so that story is continuing to unfold. This message could have been Sasha venting to someone she trusted about her losing streak and struggles with Bayley, and hints that the payback is coming for Bayley. I think that's the perfect idea and concept that fits perfectly into the latest clip from the SmackDown hacker. Another small thing that I thought wasn't getting enough attention was the caption that this SmackDown hacker posted with this voicemail teaser. In this caption, the SmackDown hacker writes, "We will rise." Now, notice how they didn't say, "I will rise." It looks like this is even more confirmation that this is not one man behind the SmackDown hacker persona. It truly is multiple hackers that are behind this entire operation. Everyone's guesses from a few weeks ago were Ali, Chad Gable, and Xavier Woods. The one from that group that I say has the best chance to be actually true is, of course, Ali. Feels like more and more evidence for Ali being one of the hackers just continues to come out each and every day. So Ali seems like the most likely one of these three. Chad Gable is still questionable, but like we noted before, he was Ali's tag team partner earlier this year. So was it possible that Ali maybe pressured him into being one of the hackers? It's definitely a possibility. Then for Xavier Woods, this is another tough one. Woods is still part of New Day. He's still recovering from his injury, and he isn't exactly lying low either. Woods is still all over Twitter, streaming on Twitch, running his YouTube channel, and what history has taught us is that when WWE is bringing someone back with a new character, they usually want them to lay low and keep a low profile online. Doesn't seem like Woods is doing that at all, so that's what makes me a little doubtful about him being one of these hackers. Fans have tried everything with the female voice message. They've tried speeding it up and slowing it down, the audio, and some believe that it sounded a lot like Mickey James or Ronda Rousey. Mickey James has been out of the storylines for months and was even commentating at one point, so don't really know how she could be behind anything. The Ronda Rousey theory is at least sort of believable. Ronda has been putting on this act lately that she hates WWE and everyone involved.
I feel like we already watched this.
Just a heel tactic to throw us off for when she returns. So could she be the one behind something? I mean, surely it's possible, but I just don't see it happening, at least right now at this point. This voicemail has to be from a woman involved in a current tag team with a relationship that's falling apart. That's why Sasha and Bayley are some of the prime suspects here.
So it could be a tag team. I'm thinking. So who could be a tag team on SmackDown? Bayley or Sasha, Alexa Bliss or Nikki Cross. Or, hold on. Can you get something on my mind? Carmelo and Daniel Brooke. Who else a team on SmackDown for the female? I don't know.
So, the Money in the Bank reveal by the SmackDown hacker wasn't about an exposure, and we sort of expected for it not to be one. He wouldn't just expose someone out of nowhere. There has to be some sort of build-up to his exposure, like the way Mandy Rose and Sonya Deville went. Everyone expected for something to be going on there, and the hacker came by when everyone already had their speculations about Sonya, and he proved them to be right about Sonya being the liar. So it looks like that's how the hacker works. He'll appear and will expose someone when they really start to show big cracks in their relationship. So the Money in the Bank clip was more about revealing his impressive yet scary massive workspace to us. And if you were expecting a reveal at the Money in the Bank, then you may be disappointed with the clip we got. But don't worry, a big reveal looks like it's on the way. The voicemail seems to be the next big clue for who he's focusing on next. All we know, besides the actual voicemail, is that he's been watching this target for several weeks now, so he'll definitely be coming with all the evidence in the world. What are your thoughts on this voicemail we got from the teaser? And what did you think of the SmackDown hacker's working space? Leave your comments, don't forget to subscribe with all notifications on, and leave a like if you enjoyed. Thanks for watching, guys.
Hey guys, I'll be back with another one. Guys, so, I want to look at this voice one more time. For the boys, I mean, look at this, look how the voice sounded like Ali for the boys actor. So why they can't even figure that out? He giving us a hint what his voice sound like. Watch this.
Were you paying attention?
Okay, was you paying attention?
I told you. The truth will be heard.
I want to take a lot of replays at this.
Be heard.
For y'all guys, so y'all can see.
I told you.
So y'all can pause the video and find out who is this SmackDown hacker.
Were you paying attention? I told you. The truth will be heard.
And one more time, guys.
Were you paying attention? I told you. The truth will be heard.
That just sound like Ali's voice. It really do sound like his voice. Mustafa Ali. It just sound like his voice. Were you paying attention? The truth will be heard. Guys, hit that like button. Smash that subscribe button. I just rang that up. And please do not miss this video I'm posting right now, guys. So y'all can figure out who is this SmackDown hacker. So y'all can tell all y'all friends who watch WWE. Hit that like button, subscribe to my channel, and also, we are trying to get to the bottom of this SmackDown hacker. And this SmackDown hacker is just not giving up. So guys, y'all heard the voice multiple times. Play 3 more times for y'all. So y'all can hear for yourself. And also, I want y'all to take a look at this. Okay. That shell, y'all see that circle? That was his own Ali gloves in his jacket. I keep telling y'all that. That's the circle on Ali jacket and gloves. And also, please tell me it's not Ali. It's got to be Ali. Yep, it's got to be him. I bet he mad because, you know, 2019, he almost had that money in the bank until snap, Brock Lesnar music play. And Ali fall out the letter. Maybe he trying to, and y'all say payback. We payback is coming. We still trying to figure out who is that female voice and who behind that voice. It's a female we already know. It gotta be AJ Lee, Ronda Rousey. Ronda Rousey says she hate WWE, Ronda Rousey says she hate WWE, and also she said she will return. So I think they gotta be the female voice, cause she said she also gonna return, and she also hate WWE. So here's my thing: if Ronda Rousey returns, she hate WWE, then she probably behind the female voice hacker who sent us that voice. Payback is coming, cause y'all know Stephanie McMahon at WrestleMania 35, Ronda Rousey, you know, I wanna put that title online. And also, Ronda Rousey was pregnant, just like Becky Lynch. But, yeah, also, Ronda Rousey said she hate WWE, also morbidly pregnant. So, y'all gonna hear the voice, and y'all gonna see the shadow on HL, y'all know, Mafia Ali. Okay, here we go, the voice. Here we go, the voice, the boy voice, not the girl.
Were you paying attention? I told you. The truth will be heard.
Mysterious hacker.
We have heard all the lies.
You see, he changed his voice.
Some keep their friends close.
Guys, I know y'all heard that. I know y'all heard that, right? Y'all gotta heard that.
Keep their enemies closer.
Let me play that voice one more time for y'all. And do
the smackdown.
And do that voice sound like Ali.
Others keep their enemies. Some keep their friends close.
Large.
Some keep their friends close. Others keep their enemies closer.
It's Mustafa Ali voice. Do he got a voice change? I think he got a voice changer. Because how he changed his voice to a mysterious hacker. Like a real hacker, guys, yeah. But he only changed that. Don't miss part 2. Bye.